Oh, it hates that. Sensors, like this one, are key to good robotic interaction. I think it's important to understand the behavior of each specific type of sensor so that when you're trying to build your robot, you'll have a better understanding of the behavior. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate two different types of sensors, an infrared or IR sensor and an ultrasonic sensor, both used kind of as a proximity sensor for robotics. This is my infrared or IR sensor. I use this tiny little board from Pololu Electronics, and it's just terrific. For the ultrasonic sensor, I'm using this standard, cheap, comes in most Arduino kits, sometimes referred to as a ping sensor. All right, so let's start with the infrared sensor. The infrared sensor emits infrared light, which bounces off of an object and comes back in, which it then reads, and gives you that brightness. You then use that brightness level in your code to determine distance. An infrared sensor is very fast, has a fast response time, has typically a short distance, but is low noise and provides really great close-up interaction like this. Like any sensor, the infrared sensor can be fooled. Let's take a look at some examples. Since this device uses infrared light, I can use a regular flashlight and it will have no response because this is not infrared light. The same is true of an ultraviolet flashlight, again, not infrared. But what about fire? Oh, it hates that. So this tiny match emits so much infrared light that this robot responds even at a huge distance. So something you want to know about before building your robot, or else the behavior might be confusing. And how about a piece of glass? How does my infrared sensor respond to that? Wouldn't the light just go through it? Oh, no, it actually sees that. So the infrared light bounces off of the glass, does not just go through it like regular visible light. And how does infrared respond to this piece of black foam? Not very well. The dark material is absorbent enough that it has a hard time seeing it. Let's move on to the ultrasonic sensor. This sensor uses sound instead of light, and like bats do, it sends out a little sound pulse, which reflects and comes back. But unlike the infrared sensor, it's not just the level of sound coming back, it's the specific type of sound that comes back. And that allows it not to be as confused by environmental noise. And unlike the infrared sensor, rather than just the relative intensity, we're going to use the time that it takes for the sound to go out, reflect off the surface, and come back. Let's take a look at how this ultrasonic sensor can be confused. Let's see how it responds to this piece of glass. Yeah, it's fine, right? This is a nice hard surface, and the sound that bounces back comes back nice and clean. It's got a good reading off of this. How does the ultrasonic sensor respond to this piece of black foam? It doesn't. This ultrasonic sensor can't see this material because it absorbs the sound and doesn't allow it to come back. And what about this terry cloth towel? Oh, again, it doesn't see this material because it absorbs all of the sound. The sensor doesn't know it's there. So that wraps it up for me in describing the differences between the infrared and ultrasonic sensors for your use in robotics projects to read proximity, whatnot. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave me any questions or comments down below. Mash those buttons, and I'll see you next time. Does that look stupid? Yes, of course it does.